In last video, we looked at problem statement. In this video, we are going to look at project planning using aims grid and data discovery. After Bhavin Patel, who is a sales director of atliQ hardware, realizes the pains and the possible solution, he will call a couple of people like an IT head or a head of data department, and he will schedule a meeting on how exactly we should do this data analytics project. And after those people are in the room together, they will brainstorm on project planning using aims grid. Now, what is aims grid? Aims grid is a project management tool, and it has four components to it. The first component is purpose. So first we want to determine what is our pain point. What do we want to do exactly? The second component is the stakeholders. So in this project, who all will be involved? So here, of course, the marketing team, the sales team who is facing these issues will be involved. The IT team will be involved. So the IT team is basically the team of software engineers that atliQ hardware has. And the data analytics teams will also be involved. So we are assuming that atliQ hardware already has a data analysis team in-house. They also have an in-house team of software engineers. Usually some companies don't keep this team in-house. In that case, they will outsource their work to some service-based companies such as Accenture, Infosys, TCS, etc. So if you want to assume that this project is exported to those companies, then those service-based companies will manage the whole thing. But here, for our project, we are assuming that all these teams are available within atliQ hardware. The third component to aims grid is the end result. After the project is over, what do you want to achieve? So we need to define that very clearly. It cannot be a vague statement that I want to generate sales insight. In our case, the end product will be a Power BI dashboard, something that a sales director or even regional managers can go and look into, and it gives you a real-time information on your sales numbers. The fourth component would be the success criteria. After the project is over, and let's say you have spent few million dollars, how do you define that the project was successful? Aims grid allow you to do that by exactly specifying your success criteria. So in this case, our criteria would be we want the cost to go down by 10%. Also, until now, the sales team and regional managers have been giving this information in Excel file. Sometimes if regional manager wants the information in more precise way, there will be a couple of people who will be manually working on merging these Excel files, you know. So there is a lot of time that is being wasted today. So we want to save our business time and cost on those operations. There are many BPO companies today that exist, and all those companies do is they will get a couple of Excel files, they will do merging, they will do some Excel formulas, you know, they do a lot of manual work. So many organizations end up spending a lot of money on these manual works, and atliQ hardware is one of them. So we want to reduce cost on that front. And one other success criteria could be we want to bump up our sales by, let's say, 5%. So after we do all this hard work, build a dashboard, we want to use it for 3 months, and we want to make sure that we have achieved all these results defined by success criteria. So the aims grid is an extremely useful tool for any project managers and leaders, which can help you manage the project in an effective way. For aims grid, I have this nice YouTube video where this person explains this aims grid in a very simple manner. So I would suggest that you watch this video. It will be very helpful in terms of improving your project management skills. So now you have defined aims grid, you know exactly what needs to happen. Then sales director will call the data analyst team, and he will start discussing that how we can solve this problem. He will also call the IT team. Now, just to be fancy, I have given this fancy name to our IT team. Let's call them Falcons. So Falcons is a team of software engineers who own the sales management system. So atliQ hardware has this sales management system, which is just a simple software that is keeping track of all the sales number. So whenever they sell any computer or any hard disk in any local region, this software is printing the invoice. So it has all the records stored in a MySQL database. And this database and this application is all owned by this Falcons team. Our data analyst team is called data masters. So the data masters will reach out to Falcons and say, hey, we want to use your SQL database because this is the database which has all the records that we need for our analytics. And what we'll do is we'll integrate MySQL. Basically, we will use MySQL as a source in our Power BI tool, and we will build a dashboard on top of it. And Falcons don't mind. Falcons say, yeah, go ahead. And this is the approach we are going to use. Now, in majority of the time, when the data volume is high, you want to make sure that your MySQL database is not affected by the queries that you are doing in your Power BI. So sometimes what people do is, not sometimes, actually many, many times, they will design a data warehouse, okay? So what is data warehouse? So data warehouse is basically you take the data from MySQL, which is also known as OLTP, which is Online Transaction Processing System. It is a very critical system. You cannot afford for that system to go down. Otherwise, your regular sales operations gets hampered, right? For you, that means business is very important. Analytics is important, but then it's a secondary thing. So what people do is they pull the data from OLTP, which is MySQL in our case. They do all the transformation, which is also called ETL, which means extract, transform, and load. And after doing that transformation, they store the data in a data warehouse. There are many data warehouses such as Teradata, Snowflake, and so on. And for doing this transformation, people use tools such as Apache NiFi, Talend, or even Python and Pandas. By doing this transformation, you are reformatting the data in a way that is based for performing analytical queries. Because if you perform your query directly on MySQL database, there are two problems. One is, if you cause that database to slow down, then your mainstream business is affected. Second problem is, the data stored in OLTP is not often in a format that you want. So you want to do a lot of transformations such as currency conversion. You want to remove the columns which are not needed. There could be n number of transformation that you want to do. And all of that happens in the ETL tools such as Informatica or Apache NiFi. And for doing this, they have this team of data engineers. So data engineers' job is to do this transformation and maintain the data warehouse infrastructure. And after that, our data masters will come in play, and data masters will pull the data from data warehouse, and they will build the Power BI dashboard. For simplicity, we are not going to build any data warehouse. We will have an SQL database, and then we will directly plug Power BI to that SQL database and build our dashboard. Now, sometimes the data that you need for analytics might not be available in your organization at all. So you might have to work on capturing that information. So many times a data analyst will spend their time, and they will capture the required information that is needed to perform the data analysis. So that's all I have for this video. In the next video, we are going to look at data cleaning and data merging. This is also known as data wrangling or data munging, whatever you want to call it. We will do all of this in Power BI itself. Now, data munging, data wrangling, these are all fancy terms. Do not worry. Actually, it's very easy. You already know. It's just that people use these fancy terms and confuse you unnecessarily. We are going to do all of this in Power BI, and trust me, you don't need any prior background for this project. Even if you don't know anything about Power BI, it's perfectly fine. Power BI is very similar to Excel actually. It is literally Excel on steroids. And we'll look into it. It's very, very easy. Even if you don't have any background, you will be able to learn it very quickly.